Hello everyone, this is Ashwin. How is it going? Welcome back to my series of tutorials on OpenCV3 and Python. In the last tutorial we saw how to read an image as a grayscale image and how to display it using matplotlib with various color maps. So whenever we display any image with matplotlib with default color map, its color is kind of distorted, right? That's why we have to use the gray color map. So this is the same code as of like last tutorial. So here we are reading a color image in grayscale mode by like passing 0 as an argument to imread function in OpenCV, and then we are using the gray color map in order to display the image with matplotlib. So let us execute this program again and let us verify the output. So this is the output. This is the gray color map for a grayscale image. Now you must be wondering why I haven't used any color. Why I haven't used any color image in order to display. Okay. So let us try to do that. So for that, first of all, we need to delete the section which mentions its color map, because we want to display the color image as it is, without any grayscale color map. And also we might want to change the mode, okay, in which the image is read. So in place of gray color map, we just need to say color image with default color map. Okay, so this is the color image with default color map, and let us execute this code now. And let us see what the output is. Now mind it that we are reading the image as it is in the color mode, and then we are not applying any sort of color map to it. Okay, so let us execute the code and let us see what the output is. Okay, so this is the output. Okay, so this is the color image with default color map. So you must be wondering why image colors are kind of like weird. I mean, the image looks weird. Correct. We have actually seen the execution of this program. I mean, we have displayed the images using OpenCV's internal imshow function, and it is not actually, the output is not kind of matching with that. We can see the colors are distorted. I mean, the image really looks weird, right, to our eyes. So this is because of a main reason. Let me explain that reason to you. And we have already seen that reason basically. So just let me remind it to you again. So whenever any image is read using cv2.imread, so it is actually stored in memory as a BGR image. Okay, so BGR stands for blue, green and red. So the planes, the channels, right? They are like saved as in the order like blue, green and red, whereas matplotlib, right, matplotlib's plt.imshow function, it displays anything, okay, any image, okay, by default in RGB mode. Okay, so RGB stands for like red, green and blue. Okay, so it is actually kind of standard amongst many libraries to read an image and then save it in RGB format, and then like while using that imshow function, it interprets all the channels in this order. Okay, so but the problem here is that we are using OpenCV for reading and storing the images, and then we are using matplotlib to display the images. So what happens whenever we read any image, okay, any color image, it reads the image, and while storing in a variable, it saves like the blue channel first, then the green channel first, and then the red channel third. Okay, and while displaying it on the screen, it interprets the first channel as the red channel, second as one is like green channel, and the third one is the blue channel. So our computer is actually, our Python program is getting confused between blue to red, okay, between blue and red things. Okay, so it interprets blue channel as red channel and red channel as blue channel. So that is actually a really big problem. But there is always a remedy for any sort of problem, right? So let us try to understand what sort of remedy we have here, okay? And the remedy lies in the OpenCV. So let us now see what that remedy is. And see, basically, this BGR and RBG that we are talking about, right? These things are known as color spaces, okay? So there, this is a very very nice concept actually, color spaces. So whenever we want to represent any sort of color image, okay? So we already know that grayscale image are like mostly 2D images, right? So two dimensional images, they have like height and width. Okay, width, it's like width. And the color images, right? Color images have got height and width and color channels. That's why they are known as 3D images. Okay, so they are like three dimensional while representing in any sort of computer system. Another thing about is that is the color images, right? They have always these color channels. Now there are various ways we can represent the color channels, okay? And various ways we can represent color channels is known as color spaces. So there are various color spaces. The most commonly used is RGB, okay? And then OpenCV, while storing the images, is it? I mean, in a variable, it uses BGR. Then there are so many other color spaces like HSV. HSV stands for hue, saturation, and value. Okay, it's like hue, saturation and value, okay. And then there is something known as CMYK, right? CMY, can, magenta, and yellow, and then CMYK and all that sort of stuff, right? And even gray is also a color space, right? Gray is also a color space. So so these are all the color spaces, and OpenCV allows us to change the color space of an image. I mean, how the image is internally represented in the variable. So in order to like fix this problem, right? Whenever we are reading this image, now the image has been read in, image has been read, and it has been stored in IMG variable in BGR color space, right? So we need to change the color space of this variable IMG. So let us try to do the same. So now there is a very good function for that. So that function is, let's see, what is that? IMG equal to CV2 dot CVT color, right? IMG comma CV2 dot color underscore BGR to RGB. Okay, so blue, green, red to red, green, blue. So this is how we are changing the color of an image, color space of an image. And let us see now what the output is, how the output is going to be. So let us execute this piece of code again. Okay. So now, as you can see, that the image has been displayed in with the proper colors and all. I mean, at least it is like much more comprehensible to the human eyes. Okay, so all it has done is that it has just changed the way the image is stored. It has been stored from VGR to RGB mode, and now it is more comprehensible to the human eyes and human brain. So, if you want to see the difference, we can do the same thing. So we will just say IMG1, and sorry, we will just like make it IMG and IMG1, okay? And we will just like copy this entire section, and okay, color image with image BGR and RGB. And finally, we can, it seems that the program is correct. Let's clear the console, and let's execute this piece of code again. Yeah, so this is like a color image in BGR mode and color image in RGB mode. Okay, so you can see the difference between both the things. And this is how we can this is how we can like properly display the images, and I mean in a way which are which is comprehensible to human eyes by using these this function, okay, cv2.cvt color. So now many of you might be wondering like how many color spaces are there, and how many how many color conversion variables like these are, I mean color conversion arguments like these are possible. So for that there is a, we can write a small programs ourselves. So let's save this program first. Save as, let's save it as program 16. In case you are wondering where you can find the code, you can find the link to the GitHub repository of this code, all these code examples in the description section down below. Do not forget to check it. Okay, so now the image has been read in this format, and so basically for this program we are not going to require any of these things. Okay, so this program that right that we are going to write is going to display the list of all the color conversion stuff. Okay, so let's initialize j equal to 0. Now let's initialize for file name in dir cv2, okay, and if file name dot starts with, okay, color underscore, then print file name and print, I guess it's old style syntax, file name, and finally j equal to j plus 1. So in the end we are going to print there are j plus 1, it should be like str of j plus 1, yes, color conversion flags in OpenCV. So let us save this code and let us execute this. So before that, let's clear the console because we want to see the complete output. Probably the output is going to be truncated because there are far too many color conversion flags available in OpenCV. So let us execute it, and it says if the name equal to main. I'm not quite sure what the problem is. Let's try to debug this code, shall we? Yes. What could the problem be? It says in 12, line number 12. So let's just comment this one and let's see what the problem could be. Now it says invalid syntax. I guess there is some problem with the print statement itself. Is there? Okay, I guess I have forgotten a closing bracket. Okay, now let's save this code and let's clear the console and execute this. Yeah, so we got the list of entire list of color conversion flags or color conversion stuff. Okay, so here you can see like from BG to BGR, I mean blue and green to blue, green, red, BG to BGRA, if stands for alpha transparency, and then BG to gray and all that stuff, right? So couple of BGR to HLS, BGR to gray is something that we are going to use very frequently. Let's list actually a couple of frequently used color conversion functions or color conversion flags that we are going to use very frequently. Okay, it's color underscore BGR to gray, color underscore BGR to HSV, okay, and color underscore BGR to RGB. So these are various color color conversion flags that we are going to use very frequently, and during, especially during our practicals, we are going to use these things, right? So yeah, so these are like so many color conversion flags available with OpenCV, and as of now in the version of OpenCV that we have installed, there are almost 275 color conversion flags. I remember to have written a book on OpenCV, and when I wrote that book almost three years ago, so there were almost 176 color conversion flags, okay, and I used OpenCV 2 and Python 2 combination with Raspberry Pi. So this is like Windows plus OpenCV 3 and Python 3, and there are almost like 275 color conversion flags. So they have like kind of added 99 color conversion flags. I mean, every flag corresponds to an algorithm, right? A mathematical algorithm which converts from one color space to another color space. So there are like so many mathematical functions which are going on. Okay, in place of BGR to RGB, it's like very simple. You just need to actually swap the blue and red planes. Okay, it's like some NumPy stuff, right? You just split that image into various channels. We are gonna see that program very soon, and then you display you just like swap the channels, and that must be like underlying algorithm. But when it comes to complex color space like BGR to HSV, then it actually takes a lot of calculations, right? You have to calculate the value of each new pixel, right? Each new set of variables using the earlier set of variables. So that is going to be quite complex, but OpenCV does all that stuff for us. So this is what this is how it looks like. So let's have a look at earlier program once before leaving. And as you can see, we are not actually using any sort of CMAP flag here, right? So this is it. This is how we convert how the image is represented from one color space to another color space for our convenience. Okay, so very soon we are going to see a program in which we are going to use this feature in while processing the live video, and in order to track the colors. Okay, so I hope that you like this particular tutorial. Just let me know in case you have actually any more suggestions to improve this program. Thanks a lot. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I will see you next time.